This program was made possible by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, the John D. and Catherine C. MacArthur Foundation, and additional support from Latino Public Broadcasting, National Endowment for the Arts, National Asian American Telecommunications Association, and others. A complete list is available from PBS. And contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
Hey, you getting married as soon as I graduate from high school. Sound familiar?
Yeah.
Y'all better start saving up and get her engagement ring. I don't see the big difference. It's just something on paper to say you married or whatever. It's gonna be the name. Yeah, you committed to her and only her.
Oh, that's a big step. I've been with Maria for almost, 16 months. She wants to get married now. I'm giving Maria a promise ring, but
not engaged.
Not an engagement, not yet. I'm ready to get engaged, but I don't want to keep her waiting for a while, and I am gonna keep her waiting for a while. And I think after a while, she's gonna want the second step. You
know? Summed it up.
What's up, baby?
Sure, I want to live with her now, like more than ever. Like before, I had lots of doubts. Like I wanted to spend at least a year after high school without her. But more time goes by, you know, I realize that I need her. I actually want her more than I'm able to have her.
Maria, all my dreams came true. When your love came into my life.
I don't want to, I'm afraid. I can't open it, I don't want to open it.
That promise, what I wrote, inside the ring, because I actually wrote out the promise. I don't know. I was thinking back of when I met her, how long I've known her, what we've been through. It just made me realize a lot. Now I know I want to be with her.
And at the bottom of where you fill in your address and phone number. What do you mean? Yeah. Okay. Also, I need to get a red
pair of shirts. Promise to love me for as long as I allow him to, and to learn everything about me, and to give all that he can to me. He wrote, Jen.
Sorry,
I just want her to know that my love is gonna keep on growing strong, and if hers is growing just as fast as mine, and we both keep on progressing and learning and evolving with each other, you will soon get married. That's my promise to her.
Derard is different. He don't game bang in school, does homework.
She's every man's dream. And I guess my dream came true or whatever when I found her.
What attracted you to him?
His smile.
What else?
When he was talking to me, he was too sweet. It's nice, couldn't say no.
What about the L word? Have you used it yet?
Nah. I mean, she tell me already that she loved me or whatever. I'm like, all right. I mean, you gotta really love that person to tell them. And I ain't in love yet.
this is the first one that I've met, and he told me, and I asked him, I said, Derard, why haven't I met any of your friends? And he said, well, Mama, I have to bring home a woman worth bringing home. So she's the first to be brought home.
Sweet potatoes.
Mama brought the wrong potatoes.
That's all they had in the store.
She's a vegetarian.
She almost close to perfect, whatever. I don't think I could have found nobody better at this time or whatever, and I don't think I will. We just moved in together. I love that girl. Yeah, I said I love her. And that's my heart, my baby.
Well, guess what? I finally applied in a modeling agency. I've always, like, pictured myself walking down that runway, people taking pictures of me, like, clack, 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 clack. You know, the stars, the action, the thrill. I've always liked that.
Where do you go, Fairfax?
Fairfax High School.
Lots of Russians?
Oh, yeah. How do you know that?
Because believe it or not, half your high school has walked into my office wanting to be models. Every Russian girl you could imagine.
Oh, gosh. So you've never done anything before?
Nope.
What's up with that hair color?
Oh, I just tried to do something different.
Because, even if I consider bringing you on board, you'd have to go back to natural color.
Okay, that's fine. I can do that.
It's just too crazy. I mean, it would really keep yourself. I couldn't really do too much. I mean, there's an agency called Dragon that specializes in crazy kids.
You know, they didn't like me with red hair, you know. They only deal with normal people.
I have an appointment on the 4th.
I really want to see my face in Hollywood and maybe see my face in a billboard sign.
I don't want to, like, be a model and, like, end up, like, my face in a food carton, you know, like, in a milk carton, you know, have you seen me or something.
Those aren't models, Jet. Those are lost children.
I know!
I like to be known. I mean, not popular, but known, you know?
This is our client, Candy Eyes. This is one of our drag queens. We've got Tori. She's also one of our models.
Here at Dragon, we mainly do, like, commercials, music videos. We also do print work and film and television. So are you interested in going out, like, across the board, or what kind of area are you interested in?
Anything. I don't know, just, like, adventurous things.
So you're just kind of, like, looking to start out, get started?
Okay. Do you work with a choreographer?
Of course.
Okay, good. Yeah. Well, it was nice to meet you.
All right.
And we're going to meet with a lot of people today. Thank you. Thanks for coming in.
I have a feeling like either way, I'm not going to get in this one. It's like no hope. I mean, look at everybody else. They look so pretty and trendy. Like, they look so not me.
All right. Good luck, Jeff.
You know that guy that took my Polaroid? He's cute.
Yeah, I didn't make it. I mean, I called like the next week, and they were telling me they only hired like two people, but like try again. And I was like, oh gosh, you know, wasted my time for that.
Yeah, you're gonna go to more agencies?
Right now, I'm just gonna give it a rest.
Come on, Mom, I know you have money. You always have money.
Yo no tengo.
It's a big wallet.
Toda la vida, está sacando dinero para ir a nada. Con Douglas,
Douglas.
Hi.
No.
Tell me more about what's going on.
My mom, she didn't know I was on birth control.
That she knew.
She didn't know this time. And she just feels like, I guess after what happened, that I shouldn't be doing anything at all.
She hasn't realized that you're grown up and you really can make a lot of decisions. Some of your decisions you're not proud of, you made some mistakes.
I mean, it's understandable that she doesn't want me to go through the same thing over again, and I don't
you're
either.
Not.
But that's the
you're
only
not.
Reason
that's
I'm
why
doing
you're on
that.
The pill, right? The way you've handled it and what you've done since then is beautiful. You know, it did stop you. You went on. You're graduating on time. You know, have a good boyfriend, all those things. So look what you've done.
Like, the reason I want to do things and I want to get my life together, you know.
It's already together. It's not get your life together. It's already together.
No, but, you know, like, do, like, things, you know, like, get a good job and go to college and everything. Uh-huh. Maybe, you know, if I do all that, then she's actually going to be like, I'm proud of you. I guess that's why I want to do it more, you know?
And what
I want to do
better. What if you don't hear it from her? What if she never says, I'm proud of you? Can you say, I'm proud of me?
Yeah, I'm proud of myself for all the stuff that I've done.
You need to be very proud of yourself.
Describe a time in your life when you were the recipient of good luck.
I got lucky when I lost everything that was of value to me. I didn't realize how important my family was until I lost it all.
I think the hardest thing is being strong and surviving. That's the hardest thing.
Being strong and surviving, what in particular?
I guess like continuing life. Because a lot of people, they want to give up, you know? Or they just want to do something else, or they don't even want to live anymore, you know? And I think the hardest thing is to get over a situation and just keep on living, you know? That's what I learned so far.
I remember when I was little, my dad and I, you know, play around, wrestle, you know, do like, you know, like sports and, you know, do fun things together. But at the same time, he would like, you know, tell me the importance of studying, and then he would, you know, like tutor me in math. And that just kind of went away, you know, after the divorce.
Who's that little baby? Elizabeth. Hey. Were you happy then, huh? Hannah, were you happy?
No.
Was he a playboy or something?
Not playboy, but like a jellyfish. You know jellyfish?
A jellyfish?
Yeah, when you see a woman, jellyfish.
You know, when I remember that day my dad left, and I was like, you know, I knew he was going to move out of the state, you know, and then I started crying, and, you know, like, he would call me once a month, but then once a month came two, and then after 2 months it became, you know, it just came to the point where now he doesn't even call me.
I like this picture a lot.
Why do you like this picture?
Because it's just like the environment looks warm, and because you have this right here.
It's supposed to represent luck, right? I don't understand how can a person have a child, like create a child and then leave.
I'm still in the process, but I would say the hardest thing is forgiveness. That's to me, at least.
I decided to take the week off.
Yeah.
School. Yeah.
What's been going on?
A lot of stuff, just throughout the last couple months, things have just not been going so well, and I decided it'll come down on me these last couple weeks. So I got depressed and upset about a lot of things, and so my mom decided, or we both decided, probably be good just for me to take a week off and take a break, get away from school for a while and just be able to be by myself, because I haven't been able to do that for a long time. And I've been taking Wellbutrin, and that's like an antidepressant. And it was supposed to help me with my ADD, but it wasn't doing anything. So, it was at first, and it's helping me emotionally. When I have like really hard time concentrating, I take Ritalin, which I don't like, but I take it for certain reasons, like for like the SAT and like during the week, like for a test or something like that. And also I've been going through all this kind of depression thing that like she told him about. He's like, well, what if we tried another antidepressant? And I was like, okay. So he started going through them, and he says, you know, the one he has most experience with is Prozac. And I'm like, oh boy. So he decided to give me that, and I started taking it like 2 days ago for depression and stuff, and I don't know if it's really working yet. It might be. But actually I heard from one of my teachers today that they call it one thing for ADD, they call them cocktails, are like the best things, is like mixing different drugs together, not like mixing them but taking them together. And she suggested Wellbutrin and Dexedrine. And I've taken Wellbutrin and Dexedrine, just not at the same time, separately. And so I might try that.
Hello, my name is Karla. My ninth grade year, first semester, I started kicking it with people I shouldn't have been kicking it with to begin with. Started messing up in school. Ditched, and when I did come, I didn't do shit. Nothing, sorry. Slipped out, sorry. I started doing drugs, and I thought it was a cool thing to do. I hit rock bottom. I decided that, you know, that wasn't the thing that I wanted to be doing. I was behind. I messed up my whole 10th grade year. Finally, my junior year, I actually passed all my classes, finished up night school, first semester of my senior year, and I'm here now.
Like, a lot of people would have given up, but like maybe in your 10th or 11th, what kept you going?
I do it for my parents, because my brother graduated high school. He didn't graduate in regular high school. He went to continuation and graduated that way. Before he got out, he found out his girlfriend was pregnant. They had a baby. I mean, he never got the chance to go to college and, you know, actually do everything. So I want to do it.
So when are you supposed to move in here?
Possibly by the end of the month. It doesn't really look like we're going to move in by the end of the month. We're going to rent these out. And then the top is going to be the house. They're knocking everything down and they're making it into bedrooms.
My mom made really good money. She used to be a secretary for the governor in Guatemala. So we had like this big house and we had a butler and we had maids and stuff. And she went to college and she didn't get married until she was 25. She didn't have kids, not until she was like 28. She did everything she was supposed to.
A lot of Hispanic people that come here either, you know, do nanny or they housekeeping, you know. And it's like, you know, everybody thinks, you know, everybody's better than us just because, you know, our parents do that. Like, my mom, she's a nanny. To me, my mom is a hard worker. She does everything to provide for us. And I'm not, like, you know, a lot of people are like, how can you say your mom does that for a living, you know? It's like, it's not a put down to me.
Woo! Look at those grades. 3 A's. Your mom is gonna just go bananas. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 excellence.
That's wonderful.
I'll do my grades where I'm top.
Well, you know what I think is real interesting? Let's look at old year, because I think you've gone significantly forward. Sure, look at this. Look at from the fall of last year.
I had 3 fails and...
And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 U's. And look at all these days absent. I think this is a definite celebration. I'm going to print these for you. So you can share them with the world. What happened?
I passed every single class. So proud of me.
Yay.
Even though I don't like the 2 D's. But it's okay. Could have been worse. Could have had a fail there.
Yeah.
Yay. Look at my absences.
Let's
say. Damn, 24. But I passed.
Yay. But you can't miss any
classes
now.
I haven't missed one day. And I've been on time every day. It's only been 3 days, but still. Hey, I'm proud of myself.
You ready?
No, never.
Yeah, you did fine. All right, this is the third part. It's called serial reasoning.
Six. One. I know that one. I read a story that has the title of that on it.
In the past, we had dexedrine and wellbutrin. Currently, this report says that she takes Prozac, but she's, but I know that that's not happening, right?
It is happening.
Oh. Last we talked, Red Bull was doing a better job for you.
So Prozac's just helping me with my depression.
Yeah, the Red Bull is, she's not taking Ritalin anymore.
Right.
And the Red Bull seems to be helping her as much as Ritalin did.
I'm gonna go on to the testing for a minute. She got a perfect score on this one. She's really narrowed the gap, and that's the whole goal, you know, special education. Her self-esteem scores have all went up a lot. The only area that was still in the area of concern, but it was like barely there, was anxiety, school-related anxiety, and then her feelings about her intellectual status, which is why I keep pressing. Where you're at, cognitively, honey, is like 2% of the population. I mean, 2 to 5%, you're very smart. Very, very smart. You have to start trusting that.
I'm still just very concerned about Schusterman's class because she just still isn't getting, I mean, she's not getting a lot of history done, but she's Schusterman, she just...
Dr. Schusterman, and I've already talked to you about this, knows that there's some things that are going on with you, but she thinks you're starting to take advantage a little bit. Mm. She thinks that maybe you're turning him later, even later than you should be turning him in. It seems like, oh, I don't have anything to do next week, so I don't have to do anything. But you're gonna have to set up a certain period of time. You're gonna have to start internalizing this a little bit more.
This is the decision. You agree that you're no longer in need of special education?
Well, again, we appreciate all your input and help and special attention.
Can we have Kendra Moore up here? Kendra!
Yeah, Kendra! Silence! Stop! Shut up!
We need everybody's attention.
Be quiet!
Go, girl!
Don't be nervous, Kendra!
Shut up! Let me the whole school!
Hi.
You don't have to be nervous. Come on, just
can
calm
I
down.
Sit down.
Yeah.
Okay. When I first entered Fairfax, I told myself I wanted to be someone memorable for my senior year. I'm not popular, but the one who's ever spoken with me, one knows that I'm a kind person.
Calm down.
Okay. Nothing I can say would make me receive more votes. But if I don't win, I say it wasn't for me. And I wish every individual here success. Thank you.
Thank you, Kendra.
I promise to use mine. I promise to use mine. Pave the way. Pave the way. mine. Nothing beats. I promise to use mine. A failure, but I promise to use mine. A try.
Nothing beats a failure.
Try again. And don't ever compare yourself to the next man. We all stars. Some of us use our shine in different ways. I promise to use mine to pave the way. Now I've done some shady things. Got some shady pay. Had some shady days. When I didn't believe in self, my folks believed in.
There's much more of Senior Year at PBS Online. Hear all the music, talk about this episode, and follow the stories you'll only find online at pbs.org. To order the entire Senior Year series on video cassette or the companion CD to the series featuring Oso Motley, Ani DeFranco, The Coup, and others, call PBS Home Video at 1-800-PLAY-PBS.
This program was made possible by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, the John D. and Catherine T. MacArthur Foundation, and additional support from Latino Public Broadcasting, National Endowment for the Arts, National Asian American Telecommunications Association, and others. A complete list is available from PBS. And contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
I'm going to prove to myself that I can be independent, and you're just going to have to understand.
I haven't had a teenager like you, ever.
Now I just need like a really fresh date.
I'm not a cheerleader. I'm not in leadership anymore. A regular student with no prom date.
This is PBS.